Hey everybody, how are you all? My name is Angie Murenga. You're watching Just Angie, and today I want to talk about naming our children and then love in that context. We're still in February, and February is the month of love. And there's something that I've just been watching, and we even had a discussion the other day with some ladies about, and this is how the dynamics of naming children, and especially children who are in the cultures where children are named after parents, you know, that and how that sometimes dynamic can really change things and cause there to be what I say, like, love sort of warped or love gone wrong. So I'd like you to really talk to me and send me in your comments and your experiences if this happened to you. But also I want us to forgive, but and then also think about it, because I'm thinking that a lot of people now are not naming like that, which I think is a really good thing. So let me say, where's my story coming from? In a family, let's say, and the culture that I come from, we're four of us, so two of us are named on one side of the family, on my dad's side of the family, and another two are named on my mother's side of the family. And what I've noticed is that sometimes that creates a rift and creates favorites. So if I'm honest to myself, my mother has favorites, and her favorites are my younger siblings, because they are named after her father and her mother. And I think that's a very, from what I've grown up knowing and seeing, my parents love me, there's no discussion about that. And we love each other as our siblings. But sometimes I just like to dig deep into situations. And sometimes when God will drop something into my spirit, and I begin to think through it, and then I know that it has an impact, and there may be other members of society who are also facing the same thing. So I want us to think about, if we're going to name our children like that, then what I would advise is not to have favorites. But I also said that we've come into a culture and a season and a generation of people who don't name after their parents, you know. You just name a child. I mean, I thought it would just be easier, you know, to name it either after a season, or you pray and there's meaning to the name, and what does this child mean? It could even be prophetic. You're saying, this is what I want to prophesy. When I think about Althea, her name means a flower that brings healing, and that's what she really has, especially to my life, and I feel like she's got a greater call to bring healing to people. So somehow that name has become prophetic and is projecting forth. So I think we need to think about what we're naming our children, and if there's a motivation and an inclination to love some children more because they are apparently named after your side of the family, I think that's something we need to stop. I think it's something we need to be very conscious and aware of and stop doing, because like for me, I was just thinking about it. I don't think it's damaged me in any way, but I know I had to deal with that and face that and look at it and face it head on, and then deal with it and pray and just say, you know, my mother is my mother, I love her. My father is my father, I love him. And we come from one family, but what does this mean? And what could potentially have gone wrong with that kind of dynamic, where you're brought up in a family where you think that your other siblings are favored over you? And so I'd like to hear from you. But I also want to, in the month of love, because we said God is love, God is a very forgiving God. And so I think I introduced the concept because I want us to be able to forgive. I want you maybe to reflect and evaluate, but forgive and let go and truly forgive and truly let go of that, and then don't continue it, you know? It's like even people come from families that are very violent or abusive. They always say they're not going to continue that violence or abuse, but they do. They are very shocked when in later life they do. Why? I think because if you don't deal with it. So I think that's what I wanted to do. In this video, I want us to deal with that. If you are in a situation where in your family, you feel that you are maybe punished, or you didn't receive all the love that you wanted because of that demarcation, because of who you're named after in the family, then I think that this is a season where you forgive and let go of that. Why? Because I also think it can hold you back. Such things can really hold you back from progressing in life. You need to call it what it is. You need not to confront. I don't think you should confront. The only person you need to maybe confront is yourself. And then you need to go into a session with your creator, with God, and just say, you know what, Lord, help me to let this go. Don't carry it forward. Don't do it now in the next family. And remember, names are very powerful. And what we name a thing, I mean, the Bible says that God made the animals and everything pass before Adam because he wanted to see what he named it, you know? That is so power-packed for me. That's why I love God's word. He wanted to see what he would call it. What are you calling it, you know? So when you have children, when God gives you own children, God gives you own family, what are you going to call them? What is going to be different about the calling, the naming, the attitude, the way that you bring them up? What's going to be different about the way that you do it? And I think you should be very conscious of that. And then don't carry pain, don't carry grief, don't carry issues don't carry issues from one generation into another generation, because I'm continuously talking about generation. So be aware what plagues your generations, what made you feel like that, and how best you cannot repeat the whole cycle. And I mean, that's another thing. People are calling their children names based on a season, based on the word of God, based on revelation, based, you're prophesying into that child's life. This child will be beautiful. This child will be blessed. This child will be a kingmaker. This child will be favored. So that's what you're calling that child, you know, and in every culture, because we have the English naming, then we have what the name means even in your culture. Be very careful what you're naming and what you're calling, because the naming and the calling comes to pass. I mean, recently I was thinking about somebody who gave me a story and said they were born quite a number of siblings, I think five, and the, you see again naming. This child was born, he was a boy, he was named after this particular man, and this particular gentleman is quite successful. And he said, crazy, he said, this one will be like me, and he'll be different and he'll be separate. I mean, just that statement, the power of words, the magnitude, we don't understand. That's all the man said. That's the person who was telling me straight to me. That's all he said. He said that this one will be like me. And out of the five children, this is actually the one who, if you consider, is successful, is actually like the one he was named after. So the one he was named after said, this one will be like me. But thank God, I pray that they are positive things, because I guess we didn't go into an in-depth conversation about what that meant. But if somebody says, this one will be like me, I'm naming this one to be like so-and-so, then you better make sure that everything about that person's life is flowing in the will of God, flowing in the purposes of God, flowing in the favor of God, because we don't want to speak life into a child and give them a destiny because of what we said. And remember, the Bible says that the mouth is too powerful. It says in your mouth is the power for life and blessings or curses and death, you know. And I think in the book of James, it says that the tongue is a small rudder, but it can turn the whole ship. And then also it says that it can light a fire. So what you speak to this child, what you name this child, and that culture will most likely be what the child becomes. So I'm asking us to be conscious about what we're naming. I'm asking us not to discriminate between the love that we show our children, simply because I feel like they were named after my side of the family. And let's be conscious of it. I think sometimes it comes unconsciously, but I want us to be conscious about it. Be deliberate about it. And this, if this happened to you, I feel that this is the season for you to ask for forgiveness and to forgive and to let go, so that we can move on without that baggage. You know, sometimes I see, I said it before, it's like a ball and chain tied to your leg. So you need to loose the ball and chain and let it go. My name is Angie Moranga, and you're watching Just Angie. God bless you. Bye-bye.